Tell me a little bit about what does stability do?
We're one of the only companies that is fully focused on what we call generative media. Actually, we don't even call it generative AI. Internally, we call it generative media because that is our sole focus. There's so many incredible areas of AI, but our expertise is really visual and audio.
Yeah, I think a lot of people are familiar with Stable Diffusion because of its kind of virality. But the reality is that, as you said earlier, you have all these tools now. You have the video capability, you have audio capability, you got 3D, you got a language model even.
Yep. We actually call our target audience and industry is really the visual media world. So it's not just film and TV and gaming and advertising, marketing. It's anyone who's expressing themselves visually. So that visual media market is, depending on your metrics, is anywhere from $500 billion to $1 trillion market. And we're looking to, we've got our sights set on disrupting that very thing.
How do the people in the creative industry see this? How are they feeling about it?
I can only speak to the conversation I've had, which has been quite a few. I think there's one side of the equation that is really, really threatened by it in many ways. And I totally understand that. And I get that because any introduction of new technology always has this kind of like turbulent moment. The other side is there's a huge embrace that's this kind of silent, maybe minority, where they understand that the AI today is the modern handing someone a microphone, or the AI today is handing someone a camera or another tool in visual media. I don't think it's the end all be all. I think that I think there's lots of things that machines and AI are really good at, and we as humans will be limited to not be as good as them. But I think in the same respect, there's a tremendous amount that humans just do a lot better. And creativity, storytelling, I think that part of it, I think, is deeply human. And a lot of the things that won't change.
Let's shift gears a little bit and talk about responsible AI. You know, here at Microsoft, in fact, I'm in our responsible AI office right now here in New York, where we have a whole bunch of people that are focused on this. These tools that you guys are putting out and that we're putting out are incredibly powerful, obviously. I mean, totally. They're making images and videos and voices. But with that comes this burden of responsibility, because the fact is, for example, you can falsify a politician doing something that he shouldn't be doing or whatever. How do you approach responsible AI?
Oh, it's quoting a movie, right? Great power has great responsibility. And this is an extremely powerful tool. That's why we love the fact that we truly have an open source model. Not necessarily in name alone. And I think that the democratization is one step in that direction. The second step is really making sure we have a sanitary and really clean, as best as we absolutely can. And we spend a lot of time in safety integrity to make sure our data set is compliant with those values, that we're not recreating like celebrities or politicians or things. And you know, the AI won't know what those things are if it's actually not trained on it, right? There's no such thing as AI without data. So it starts with that point. And also there's other filters that we have developed on top for special, cases to make sure that we don't generate those types of images, in particular celebrities and not safe for work and politicians. Because that is something that's enormously, enormously important and, quite frankly, pretty scary.
So why are we talking? I mean, what benefit does Azure AI Foundry, what benefit does it bring you and stability to be associated with Azure?
Well, I think that Azure, in particular, Azure AI Foundry, really perfectly aligns with the vision that we have in making our advanced AI tools more accessible to ensure that artists and creators can run AI models efficiently in the cloud is part of that democratization process. And so I think that's why, we make a great team here, Marco, but also you also care deeply about safety and security. And so I think that all our values really line up.
So in the Azure AI Foundry, we have this model catalog and we have mostly large language models in there. We really have nothing like what Stability is offering yet.
Listen, large language, this is the next generation. Like, you know, a picture is worth 1,000 words. Okay. And so I think that, and there's 24 pictures a second in our video model. So I think that we could do something about that, and we should.
Can you use it to give me hair?
You know, it worked for me. So I think that, I think,
wait a minute.
We can give you hair. We can give you lots of hair.
Oh my goodness.
We can give you all kinds of styles as well.
I feel like maybe a mustache is called for too. You know, you can put that. So what comes next? I mean, what's really exciting you about where you're going to take stability going forward?
I think about things that are going to change in the future, obviously a tremendous amount, but I also think about what's not going to change. And what's not going to change in my mind is an artist sitting, grabbing, if they have a song idea, they grab a guitar and they sit there and they start messing around. And I think that is why I want to bring AI into that workflow, into making sure that we understand what's going to change and what's not going to change, and integrate into the things that aren't going to change, that actually just take the non-creative workflows, which there are a tremendous amount of in a creative project, out the door. So we could just get to the great, you know, stuff and the real creative work.
Prem, thank you very much for joining us.
Oh, thanks for having me, Marco. I'll see you soon.